This video is going to show you the game gem pipe tool. So by default, when you load in the pipe tool, you will see a curve, so we can edit the curve and easily decide the direction we should go take with the curve. Then we have, of course, some base settings, so we can define a style. So we have the basic pipe, which is what you see now. We have the smooth and the cables. So these also have different tabs. So based on what you style is, you're going to have to also go to the different tab here. So here also we have the amount. So now it's set two pipes based on the line. You can, of course, have just one pipe, one line. We can, of course, increase this as well, like this. We can also here decide the spacing, so you can space these out more. Then here we have our overall radius, bevel, divisions, and so on. Then we have the smooth pipe, so this will be a smooth version of the pipe. You can define the spacing, and we also have the radius here as well. Then we also have cables. So let's say you want to quickly drag some cables around the scene. This is also again based on here with the amount. So if you only want one cable, set this to one. Then the cable itself also has options like the radius and so on. Also interesting here at the bottom is actually solve overlapping. So it can happen like, for example, here, that by default these are overlapping quite a lot. So if I solve overlapping, they will actually try to have some more space between them. Then also at the last we have the output here, so we have a normal, and we also have here actually the direction of our curves. I can, for example, set it to z-axis, so you can see that the orientation is way different now than it was before. So we can create interesting pipes and cables quickly around a scene.